Hey guys, welcome to Learning Accounting, and today I want to talk about exam approach, basically for the ICANN students, how to prepare yourself or how to make sure you're able to prepare to pass your exam. Now, this is another area that a lot of people usually have challenges with. You find people writing exams and they are failing and they're asking themselves, why have they failed? As a matter of fact, I'll share an experience where, you know, a candidate called my school, and I picked the call, and he was very furious with us, you know, accusing us that he was a 2-1 student, he was a first class student, I think so, and that he had never failed any exam, and why would he be failing ICANN exam, you know? He was practically putting the blame on us, and I let him understand that for him to have failed, of course, it means he actually failed the exam, because I think the institute has a reputation to keep, so they would not just fail you for failing you. Of course, you must have done something wrong, and that's the reason why you must have failed. So what can you do to help yourself to pass the ICANN exam? So the first thing is in respect to the type of courses you're taking. Now, most of the time, people are not guided by the type of courses they take. You find them taking probably all the course in one particular segment of exam in respect to either the foundation level or the skill level or the professional level. Now, they just take any particular exam and just write. Now, most of the time, you must make sure that whatever course you want to write actually matches. For example, you might be considering taking financial reporting with public sector accounting and finance, which actually goes hand in hand, or you might want to take the CSME with the performance management, which also have some relationship at the skill level. At the professional level, you might want to consider audits, advanced audits, and the corporate reporting exam. And of course, you might want to choose to do tax with it, or choose to do tax as a separate exam, or choose to do case study and tax, or choose to do one of the theoretical courses, which is the case study exam and the SFM, you know. Try to make sure that you even the balance so that you don't have to choose all the papers. Now, another issue students usually have is they have the perception of they want to qualify on time. So because the ICANN has given us a structure that you can write maybe 2 times in a year, or you can now write 3 times in a year, you find students, they want to qualify on time, so they take all the paper. Now, it's not really advisable to do that. Take your time and write your exam. It's better to write and pass than to take so much paper and then failing all the paper, because you've not been able to channel your resources properly. So in respect to selecting of your exam, I prefer maximum you take 3 papers or 2 papers in a diet where you'll be able to prepare adequately. But if you have time, you're not working, of course, you could take more papers. Of course, I've seen people that wrote 5 papers and pass it at once, but you can count them. They are not very common. So I will always recommend you take lower papers so that you could do well in the exam. Now, another issue that students usually have has to do with the exam itself. Now, in the exam hall or on the exam day, you find the approach students use in answering questions are usually wrong. Most of the time, they read through the paragraphs and don't understand it because they've not understood the requirements of the question. So the requirement of the question is actually key. Make sure you read the requirement, understand the requirement before reading through the question paragraph. That way you'll be able to guide yourself towards answering the question appropriately. Now, talking about another issue, I think another issue has to do with psychology, because a lot of time perceptions also affect students, where they've heard myths of people failing a particular course very often. They tend to be scared of that course, and it also have an impact on their performance. So this is actually an issue. So make sure you clear your head, you're focused, and I'm very sure you'll do better. Another issue that you could see where students usually have challenges has to do with understanding the content. A lot of time, students don't give themselves room to read enough to prepare for the exam. They, like I've mentioned in one of my previous videos, they like cramming, or they just use an easy approach. Probably just, let's solve 10 diets and they are sure the question will repeat itself. Now, this doesn't happen all the time. it's better to understand the concept note of each topic, and from there be able to apply it in any scenario it appears, than to cram it in this particular concept, and where a small information changes, it affects everything that you have learned. So it's very important that you don't cram, but you understand the in-depth concept of every topic, and this will help you to, you know, pass your exam. Now, talking about that, another thing is to have positive mindset. Now, positive mindset, because don't think you've written an exam, then tell yourself, I failed. Come on, you have to be encouraging yourself. Whenever you write an exam, tell yourself you've passed the exam. At least that encouragement might just help you to also pass that exam. Of course, I'm not saying you should not write anything, but you should have a positive mindset. Now, talking about that, another issue again that I've identified is, you know, not preparing yourself enough for the exam. In terms of the day of the exam, not putting all the things you need to put in place before the exam, like your exam docket, like your pen, your pencils, whatever you need to use in the exam, or your calculator. Most of the time, where you find out all the location of the exam and all that, most of the time, where you didn't prepare adequately before the exam, and you have to then rush to the exam hall, you might find yourself losing time, apart from losing time, losing concentration to be able to even write the exam and pass. So you need to be able to be there on time. You need to make sure all your info, all the necessary documents or pen and all that you'll be needing for this exam are available, so that you don't start worrying yourself when you get to the exam hall. Then for me, finally, I think the last thing I'll mention is that you should always put whatever you are doing in prayer, of course, because prayer is important. I usually tell my students that the reason why you're praying is you don't want your script to just be after a particular script that offsets the marker, because the marker is a human being, is emotional, and if someone has provoked him, of course, people's scripts can provoke the examiner or the marker. So if someone has provoked him, he can pour that annoyance on your own script, which is where the God factor comes in. So you need to put it in prayer that the examiner is in the right sense of mind to mark your script, and it gives you the right mark. I believe if you're able to take each of this step of advice I've given, it might just be the one that will help you in these coming exams. So again, I would like you to subscribe on our videos, and I'll be seeing you again in another session of our video. Have a wonderful day.